This is the day the Lord has made. We rejoice always and be glad in it.
Hallelujah.
We are happy to see you again today. Amen. God bless you.
Amen.
We appreciate you always, and we know that we value you.
Amen.
God bless you. We are here today because we know you are there.
Yes,
God bless you.
Amen. It's another day.
Yes.
We need to worship God for who He is, for what He is doing in our lives. I want to thank God for your life.
Yeah.
Just like what my wife said. Knowing fully well that you are there gives us a lot of courage.
Oh, Sanjela.
God bless
May
you.
The Lord bless you all the time.
Amen. Amen. All right. So please share the video, everyone watching. Both in Nigeria and outside Nigeria, wherever you are watching from, please make sure you share the video and you watch. And you do a watch party of this program. To God alone be all the glory. This is Relationship Tees with Pastor Ake Anyowale live on Facebook. We are here. The Lord bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. All right, so we always say and tell you that
relationship is everything.
That is what we preach.
Yes.
That's our gospel.
That's what we believe in.
That's what we believe in. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
In the highest.
Hallelujah.
So the Lord bless you. Today promises to be very, very wonderful.
Amen.
All right. We started a series yesterday, which we are going to continue today.
Amen.
Common mistakes in
relationships.
Common mistakes in relationships. That's what we are looking at. All right. And we started off with finance,
which is very key. Finance. I said something yesterday. There's no romance without finance.
Romance without finance is frustration.
So please, we need to seriously sit down and consciously deal with finance in marriage or in relationship. So that by the time we have a clear mind about it, we'll be able to have a smooth ride in our journey.
Glory to God. Finances is very important to good romance, okay? If you want to get rid of some nonsense, tension, you know, misunderstanding, unnecessary quarrel, okay? It's finance that put pressure on relationships,
exactly. Mostly,
majorly, and especially not because the absence of finance, but because, like my wife said yesterday, that when you are secretive about your finances, when you are not open, okay, then it gives room for insecurity
and lack of trust.
Lack of trust, okay. Insecurity and lack of trust. The woman is like,
I don't know.
You don't know what your husband is earning. The wife does not know, the husband does not know anything about the finances of the wife. So there is a lacuna between the two of you.
That's right. That is big gorge and
everybody is not looking. I don't know what he's doing with his money.
If he drops 50 naira, I will drop 20 naira because I don't know.
Something like that, okay? So
he's speculating.
Exactly. That's what we are looking at. And I remember yesterday we said that one major thing that you must avoid, one major mistake that you must avoid in a relationship is that my money is my own.
That's a major mistake most people go through. Okay. You feel that at the end of the day, I'm the one that worked for it. It's my added money, okay? So I have total authority on it. Once you are married, like it's rightly discussed, relationship is everything. Once you say yes, I do to your husband or your wife, your money is no more your money. You are open to, even if it's 50 naira, don't feel inferior.
No.
Even if the husband is getting less, don't feel inferior because you are getting less. Things can still turn around.
Definitely,
by the grace of God. So whatever you are, don't hide anything. Make sure you are open. Make sure he knows. You know me. This is what I earn. This is what I'm getting. But I believe God to work more.
Openness is one.
It will save you a lot of headaches.
We said number two, secretive. When you are secretive about things in marriage, then it's a major mistake. When you are secretive, when you are hiding.
You are not transparent enough.
Yeah, you are not transparent.
The Bible says, like we said yesterday, that they are both naked in the garden and they are not ashamed.
They were not ashamed. They were naked and
ashamed. They are not ashamed. That means there's nothing hidden there. There's nothing needed. Let your party, your partner, your spouse, the person you're working with in the relationship, whether you are married or not, we're talking about you being transparent with each other. Let him know who you are. Let him know what you earn.
That is, we're talking about married couple.
Yes, married.
When my wife said, whether you're married or not, what we're talking about is that you are in
relationship.
In your relationship, your marital, majorly, we're discussing in your marriage right now. You need to be open. Well, if you're not married, maybe you're a spouse or whatever.
Fiancé.
There may be some, there may be some balances, checks and balances that you understand until your relationship gets to
a mature particular, to
a particular stage. Yes, maybe you are engaged, for example. You may choose to. There is an important aspect that we're going to be looking at tomorrow by the special grace of God, and that is the issue of
joint account. We're going to deal with that tomorrow.
Tomorrow by the special grace of God, because that alone is causing a lot of crisis at home, joint account and all that. We'll look into that. But today, we want to proceed further on some common mistakes.
Yes, in finances. So, we're still dealing with finances.
Okay, so what are we, what?
By the grace of God today, we're going to be talking about the mistake of you planning on your partner's pocket. my dear, it's not funny. It's not a funny matter because we discovered in some areas, my husband most of the time counsels some people, and we discover that the wife is solely dependent on the husband's
pocket. That okay, it's the duty of my husband.
I am married. You are my responsibility, and you put
everything must be on him. It's a major mistake. Two people coming together in marriage shows partnership, shows that both are responsible. Okay, both are responsible. You don't, it's just like friendship that I need to pay my house rent. I am now planning on the fact that, oh, my friend, oh, brother A,
I should be able to get some amount from you.
You know, when we're in school, a lot of people, a lot of brothers made this mistake that, okay, the reason why they want to marry someone that has British passport is a citizen. Prospect. Okay? The prospect that, oh,
once you're a citizen, oh God, I know one thing.
And let me tell you something. Most of those calculations and permutation did not work.
Even if it works for some of those initially,
didn't work because the motive alone
is wrong.
It's wrong.
It's a mistake.
You don't marry someone because of, okay, he's comfortable.
There's something in his hands. Yeah, there's something in his background that you are looking at. You are aiming at.
That he should be able to sponsor he will give me money. He will do this. Listen. There is nothing wrong in your spouse being comfortable. We are not talking about that.
More than you.
Yeah,
it happens a lot.
You getting married somewhere that is comfortable.
Buoyant more than you.
Yes, I am a fan of that. That you should be comfortable with two of you. But now, what we are saying is that don't make that your motive. Don't plan on your wife's money. There are some men that very, very interesting.
Very sad.
Okay. Because the wife is comfortable now, you don't do anything.
You sit down at home, watch TV on video, what you are not supposed to be doing. You lay around, you lie fallow. You are very lackadaisical.
As a matter of fact, if there is anybody like that, I think he's a boy. It's only a boy that can do that.
I'm telling you. Okay. Well, you are not a chico.
Only a boy that can do that. It's only a boy that will, you know, leave your responsibility for
only one person.
Either you're a man or you're a woman. That does not show maturity.
Exactly.
Maturity is taking up responsibility. Maturity is identifying that this is my duty.
And no matter how small, you are walking towards it.
And you assume that responsibility. You pick it up
joyfully, and you are not shying away.
You are not shying away. You are not passing the ball
to somebody else.
Planning on their own. Planning on their comfort. No, that is not maturity. And marriage is all about maturity. It's for two mature people that are ready to take responsibility. So it's a major mistake
for you to plan on your wife or your husband's income.
Just build a tabernacle
around it. Thank God she's any much.
No, she should be able to do that. I mean, she'll
foot the bill. She will.
And whether he or she is doing it genuinely does not mean
you not take advantage of
it. A mature person will not take advantage of the other partner. You won't do that. Yes, we are not talking about there are situations
where you have to help out.
Yes, there are many situations where my wife is there. There are so many situations we said yesterday. There were times in our lives that I was not making anything. That's the truth. Money was not coming in through me. Okay. And she is the only one. That is for that period of time. And even in that period of time, you will still see me.
Yes, you see the eagerness. You see the he's always trying.
You know,
always
I'm not
striving.
Comfortable with that.
No. My husband is not like that.
Okay.
No.
And the same thing. There are times that I will be the only one that is bringing in something. And she's not bringing. And I see the fight.
Exactly.
I see what do you call it now?
The zeal. The passion. Bring something onto the table.
I must do something. That is for the mature person. Marriage is for mature people. So it will be a major error, a major mistake
for you to now plan on somebody's health income or finances.
Yeah, to sit down and plan on your spouse's finances. No, you have to make your own. That's what we said yesterday. You have to. For somebody that can take care of himself. Somebody came to me and said, you want to marry? I said, okay, that's beautiful.
Can you take
what are
yourself?
You doing? No job. Okay. What are you doing? Do you have a house?
and believing God. Okay.
Okay. What do you have at home? I'm believing God. How do you want to go about it? I'm trusting God it will work. No.
You are not ready.
You are not ready.
Okay. That's a simple truth.
Marriage is not that somebody will take care of me. By the special grace of God, I'm telling my kids, okay, my children, these who are ladies,
you have to make it on your own.
Yes. You have to learn how to undo yourself, take care of yourself first.
So that anybody that comes your way, you will be an added value to the person, not a liability.
Thank you.
Have taught them this, we are sinking it every day in their brain, that you are an added value, you are not a liability. I am not a liability to my husband by the grace of God. You are an asset, thank you.
Okay, so you don't sit down and begin to, you know, permutate on somebody else and said, okay, he's supposed to take care of me. Yes, you're not making light of that. Yes, your husband should take care of you, because a man that will not take care of himself,
that would say it's worse than an
infidel. Yes, there's no doubt about that. But what we are saying is, don't now sit down with that.
Doing nothing.
No.
Answer.
No.
My husband is there.
No.
I am his lover.
My wife is there.
No.
Okay, we take care. No. That's a major mistake. You should be responsible to yourself first. Okay.
Before you take care of somebody else.
Every man that wants to marry should be able to take care of himself first before you invite another person into your life.
And
every woman should be able to take care of herself first before you enter into another person's life.
Open your heart to somebody else.
Okay, so it's major. Avoid that mistake.
Please.
Avoid that pothole of saying, my husband
will do everything.
My wife will do everything. In fact, it's an insult for you as a man to not sit down at home.
We do not sit down well. It's an advantage. Let me take it now.
For you to sit down at home and your wife, don't let us go there. It's a major mistake we should avoid. Okay? Money is important too. It's very important to romance. You had my wife, there is no romance without money. Money makes a romance to be fluent. Okay, it will be sweet. The thing will be rolling. The music will be sweet. Okay. All right. So number two today.
Okay. Number two today is what we want to talk about: friends and family.
Good.
Friends and family.
The mistakes. We are looking at finances.
Finances. Okay. What are our responsibilities as couple to our friends and family, and how do we undo it?
How do we undo finances of friends and family? That is, I want to give to my friends.
Exactly. And I want to give this to my parents. How do we go about it?
Oh my God.
I have to take it as a sole responsibility without my husband's knowledge. No.
Because it's my money.
It's my money. I can do anything.
I send my mommy to US.
I send my younger brother to Yale. You know, it's none of your business. It's my money and I spend it as I like. You're in a relationship. Please.
There are a lot of error in that, because some couples came to me and said, I don't think they should bother my wife how I spend my money.
What I do with my money.
Okay, no, it will bother her. Okay, because the two of you
are one.
The two of you are in that. And you see, one thing that every man should know is that your wife loves you so much that she will not open her eyes for you to enter into a ditch. No, your wife will never open her eye except she does not love you. Okay, she will always strive to see that you do the right thing. Okay, so our solution to this issue of friends and family is this. Just like what we said, number one, discuss it. Yes, it's your money. I can give to my friends. I can give to my father.
But not without my consent.
Okay, but discuss it. It's important. Every family has their own formula. Financial formula, financial responsibility, how you want to take care of it. God bless you, Sister Dupe.
Thank you.
God bless
you. Thank you.
All the way from Abu Dhabi in Dubai. God bless you.
God bless you.
We celebrate you in the name of
Amen.
You.
Amen.
Okay, so we said it's important that you discuss it. Even though it's your money, and you want to learn, you want to give to your friend, or you want to give to your parent,
or you want to borrow somebody money.
Discuss it. It's important.
Please.
Discuss it. Like we said, don't give room for assumption. Don't give room for you call it something,
speculations.
Yeah, and don't let insecurity set in. Because you don't understand. You can imagine giving to your parent without the knowledge of your spouse. It's a good thing, but you see, if you don't discuss it, it's somehow it can boomerang. Okay, so talk. There was a time I wanted to give to my in-law. Okay, I wanted to give. Okay, I want us to give because everything we discuss. So I was having an amount in mind that okay, why don't we go give to this so person? And my wife said no, don't do that. I think I wanted to give to my friend. Yes. So, and there's a particular amount I want to give to my friend. So she said, no. Don't do that. Do it better this way. And I was saying in my mind, look at it. What kind of thing is it? Do you know how much I have? But you see, there's a reason why she's saying that, okay? Every time that you want to give to others, discuss it, okay? Finances in marriage or in relationship should be discussed before you take that step. Abi, what do you feel?
That's it.
You should talk about it.
You should make it known to your partner, no matter how you have, no matter how small or how big. Make your partner let her be aware. Let him be aware of what you're doing, so that you'll be on the know. The two of you will be on the know. There won't be like somebody coming behind and say, your husband gave us, and you'll be like, that's what we discuss now. We discuss that you should give them only 100,000, and at the end of the day, I heard it's 80,000. Are you getting what I'm saying? Nobody will now come between the two of you, and it can cause a lot of these are some mistakes people make. We discuss it and we delegate. We discuss it and delegate. Whatever you discuss, stay on it. Not that we discuss A and we went ahead and do the B. No. Discuss it and let it be executed as it being discussed.
Now, there's something about finance that makes it very, very important. The money is so important that it competes favorably with God. That's how God said, you can't serve God
and mammon.
And mammon. Okay? So, it's important that you discuss it. You discuss it. If care is not taken, it can take the place of God.
It's very dangerous.
It can hold your relationship
ransom,
tight.
Yes. Okay. Hold you down there.
So you need to talk about it. You need to talk about it and agree on a position. Okay, concerning the school, if money comes into our hand, how do we go about it? What's the first thing? Okay. Does your spouse believe in tithes? Okay. That's how you have to discuss.
Exactly.
You have to have family financial standard. Okay, once money, and like you said yesterday, that's why you have to be open. If 100,000 comes into our hand
right now,
there are ways.
Lay down rules, okay, and steps. Yes.
What we should do.
What's the first thing?
What should do
second?
Okay.
They call it scale of preference.
Yes, and budgeting.
Exactly.
Okay, you have a budget. You know what to do, you know what you are working on. If you have a project, how do you run it?
Exactly. Out of that 100,000, you know all those things can be done.
Yeah.
Without headache.
Yeah.
Once you agree, we take it one after the other. Number 100,000, 30 is first in our family. We
have 100,000. Your uncle is asking you for 150.
150.
How do you run
it? And you still want to extend out of it. So you have to sit there and agree. If not, it will make the head of the two of you.
You have
a serious challenge. So the best is
to give to others.
Your friends and family are involved in it.
Look at this.
Elisha Didan.
From South Africa.
Wow. God, good to hear you. From you. God bless you and your home.
And happy birthday.
Yes, in Arias.
Glory to God. Sorry about that. We have to congratulate you on life like this. God bless you and your home in the name of Jesus Christ. All right. So, as we said, to give to your friend, to give to your parents,
family, your relations.
Okay, you must have a budget for
exactly.
that. Don't do it.
Don't overdo and don't do less.
And don't do it. Don't do it as me. If I'm giving to my parent now,
you want to show.
You know,
no.
I'm not giving as myself. Okay,
he's giving on behalf of all of us.
Yeah, And I think some family they have they have agreed at a time. I know of a family that anything they want to do, they do it through the wife. If they want to give to their parent, it's through the wife. Both parents, okay? If they want to give to anyone, it's through the wife. You design what works for you.
Whatever the kind of skeleton you want to, you sit down and chat it out. Chat it out. Every money that's going to others, apart from personal need, is going through my wife. Or it's going through my wife.
That's right.
Sure, you understand. That's so, right. And nobody will read meaning to it because that's what you are. That's your own pattern. And your model in your own way.
Yes. Just have a formula. Have a pattern.
A style.
Yes. That works with you.
Yes. And once everybody know, they won't need me at all to anything.
You are safe. And you will avoid a lot of potholes.
A lot of headache
will be taken care of. Okay. You know that if money comes in, this is number one. Whether your partner is there or not. And it gives room for confidence. It gives room for trust.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
For trust. There are some things that there is nothing. Somebody wants to tell me now about my wife, about her finances. She knows everything.
Exactly.
So it's difficult for clashes to come as a result of finance.
Mm.
And she does not put pressure
at all.
We did say yesterday that have you ever wondered of families that all their total income is about 20,000
naira,
and they have peace.
And they are moving ahead. They are forging ahead in life. Their children are fine.
Because they are discussing.
Their standard of living did not give them a day.
Yeah.
Because they agree together and they know how to manage that small. That you call small.
Yeah, yeah. They know how to manage their finances together. Why? Because they are first of all open. The wife trusts the
husband. That will do due diligence.
It's just like my wife now. She knows what is coming.
It's everything.
It would be wrong and wicked of her not to say
that. Not a demand. That want to buy a gold.
She, for her not to now tell me that I should go and buy her aeroplane now, she will be joking.
You will buy, you still buy.
I know, but not now.
You still buy.
She will be joking if she is putting pressure on me now that, you know what?
We need to change that car. We need to change that car.
Buy me a Jeep. Buy me a G-Wagon. Wow. She can't even do that.
I won't do that.
You know what? Because she
everything
knows.
Everything is so transparent.
If she sees one of her friends now driving a G-Wagon, and
I thank God for your life.
She will only thank God.
In Jesus' name.
Okay. Because she knows that, what comes in, we are going to get there.
Amen. By the grace of God. By the grace of God.
But for now, she can't put that pressure.
I can't.
So that's why.
Because I don't want him to die before his time. I don't want him to start thinking of robbing bank or stay above or breaking bank. No.
So for me now to not put pressure on my wife and say, no, you know what?
All your mates are
I want to build a house in the village for our parents. Okay, so you will be giving me every month 1 million naira or 2 million naira.
You know everything.
That means I'm not reasoning because I know what comes in from her. You understand that kind of thing? So that's why you have to be open. You have to discuss everything.
Mm.
So you are giving to your friend, you already have a budget for that. You are giving to your parent, you already have a budget for that. So there is no need that, why are you giving so amount to your own father? You are not giving to my own
parents.
There is nothing like that.
Agree on what you are making. Place them on salary. Agree on the salary that you are going to give. If you
based
say
on
our
what
both, yes. Based on one cousin, target monthly our parents. This is what is going to them.
Yeah.
And then, but as God blesses you, you are increasing it by the grace of God. Are you getting what I'm saying? But it's duly discussed.
So, finances are there to be discussed. Be open
This brought me to one scenario I have at hand. There's a particular one of the parents, or one of my parents in school.
That your husband,
that I was talking to. One of them is the husband is not around. He's not in Nigeria. And duly, he sends money. The woman too works. You understand? But her mom stays with her in the house because the husband is not available and she's heavily pregnant. She understands. So most of the time when he sends the money in, the woman, because the mother has a challenge, she quickly borrow the money out of the one husband gave her to do the mom's role. Eventually, when the husband got to know Igumoyan, the husband did not like it, and he cut short. He cut short totally. In fact, there was like 3 months that I didn't speak to her. He stopped speaking with
Because she didn't discuss with her husband.
She didn't know. She didn't go by the term that they have laid down. There's a particular lay down before the husband leaves or left Nigeria.
Stay
with the format in your home. Don't say because he's not around now, I can quickly dabble, I can quickly maneuver. It will not go well.
It's important that you stick with your plan.
I know of
some people that came to me for counseling. That the wife, you know, the wife has a good good intention. She was building a house without the knowledge of the husband. What do you call that? That is breaking of trust. Okay, it's a good thing. Quite well that you are doing, but it needs
maybe
to
she
discuss.
Wants to do it as a surprise.
No matter what, you have to discuss. There is another one that came to me. Don't let my husband know. And that's how she was swindled of a large sum of money. How do you do that? So she would now be running everywhere to recoup the money, so that because the husband must not know. You don't need to go through all those
stress.
You don't need it. There is something I want to buy that my wife will not be aware. There is something she wants to buy that will not be aware. Even though it's secret or it's to impress me or whatever.
Exactly.
We know. It's very important. So make it open. They were open.
And they
were
not
naked.
And they are not ashamed. That means there is no secret between them.
Naked are not ashamed. That's the rule. Naked are not ashamed. Naked are not ashamed. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
All right. So we've been able to talk about two things now. The mistake of
building on your spouse's bank accounts or his income. It's a mistake.
It's a major
Don't
mistake.
Do it.
You have to make your own money. You have to be responsible for yourself. It's very important. Okay? Very, very important. Don't say, my wife will do everything. Because my wife earns more than me, then she should do everything. No. That will not make it right. Or you said, my husband will carry all the loads. After all, my husband's money is for me and my husband's money is for me and my wife, and it's for
and
my
children.
And my own money
it's
is for
me.
So what would that be for the husband?
God will take care of me.
Okay. So it's important that we discuss about this.
Yes.
And you agree. For two mature people in marriage or in relationship, I believe you should be able to take care of yourself first
before you take care of another person.
So you must be making money yourself. Mm. Okay, don't plan on another person's
pocket,
your husband or your
wife,
as the case may be. Strive. Okay, yes, you may have challenge, discuss that. That does not mean
no condition is permanent.
Okay. Glory to God in hands. I hope this bless you today. Glory to God. By the grace of God, tomorrow we are looking at the issue of
joint account.
How do we do that? Is it necessary? Should we do joint account?
For what now?
For what?
I'm the one making this money.
Why? What should be the percentage?
Okay, exactly.
How do we go about
it? We're
going to be looking at that tomorrow by the grace of God. Is joint account even necessary?
Why? What for? Why?
Does it work? Mm. Okay, what about? We'll be looking at that generally tomorrow, God's willing. And I believe you are going to be blessed.
Amen.
In case you have any question, please don't hesitate. Type it. You have any contribution, send it to us also. You can send it to our inbox, or you can send it on the comment section, or you send it to us through email. We'll check it and look at it. Your feedback means a lot to us.
Thank you so much. Want to know that you are getting something and you are being blessed.
The Lord bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. We want to pray for your home today. Can you pray for us, please?
Shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we just want to thank you and appreciate you for these people that you have brought our way today. Thank you, Lord, for their homes. Thank you for their families. Lord, we decree this family watching shall be blessed in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we ask in the name of Jesus Christ for open heaven over this home in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever their desire is, Lord of heaven, you are the one that seated in heaven and you rule it in the spheres of men. Father, take up their challenge and solve it in the name of Jesus Christ. That is our desire. He says, I wish above all things and you prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospering. Father, whatever their heart desire, I cause a turnaround in the name of Jesus Christ. I decree a change in the name of Jesus Christ. This amount of mercy, mercy will speak for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ, in your finances, mercy will speak.
Amen.
In your body, mercy will speak.
Amen.
In your fruitfulness, body, mercy will speak.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus
Christ,
in this time of whatever situation you find yourself, mercy will bail you out in the name of Jesus Christ. And I decree open heaven for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Shall be well with your children.
Amen.
Shall be well with your wife.
Amen.
Shall be well with your husband.
Amen.
Shall be well with your nation.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. The
Amen.
Work of your hand. The Bible says, I will bless.
Yes.
I command blessing upon the work of your hands.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. So shall it be in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Your children shall be great.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Thank you, dear Father.
You.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. It is well with you in the
Amen.
Name of Jesus. In case you watch this video, please, and you're not born again, there's some way you can understand fully what we're talking about. Okay, it takes the Spirit of God
to interpret
to work
to
and to interpret
yes.
what we're talking about, to really, really understand what we're talking about. You need to give your life to Jesus. Okay, in case you are there, you want to enjoy the peace of God over your home, put your right hand on your chest as you pray this prayer together. Say, Father, the name,
Father
of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
I come to you today, as a sinner.
Forgive
me my sins. Jesus, come into my heart. Come into my life. I receive you as my Lord and as my Savior. From today, I am born again. All things are passing. Everything has become new. Satan, I reject you. I belong to Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for receiving me. In Jesus' name. Amen. In case you pray that prayer, you are born again.
Hallelujah.
Your face may not change, but something has changed inside you. Believe me, believe me. You are
Thank
a new
you, Sister
creator.
Cordelia. God bless
All
you.
All right, God bless you, wonderful man of God. The Lord bless you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It is well with your hope
Amen.
In the name
Amen.
Of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So, join a Bible-believing church close to your house. I'm sure there is one very close
to you,
to your house. Join them. Nobody grows in isolation.
That's
you need
right.
that relationship
to grow.
Alright. In case you are in Ogba, close to Ogba in Ikeja, Lagos, then we would like to be your pastor. Join us at Splendor Church International, number 43 College Road in Ogba, Ikeja. We'll be glad to receive you. The Lord
yes.
bless you in the name
yes.
of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Relationship
it's
is everything in life.
Life.
That's our gospel.
Yes, that's what we
that is our belief.
Yes.
That's what we preach.
Yes, yes.
Share this video. Join us tomorrow on Instagram by
3 p.m.
We'll be hosting
yes.
Dr. Apat.
Oduwale,
that's my coach. Glory to God. Make sure you join us on Instagram tomorrow by 3 p.m. We are going to be here tomorrow again on this Facebook by 1 p.m. So don't forget.
Okay.
And by 3 o'clock today, I'm going to be praying for you on Agree With Me
Hallelujah.
On this platform.
Hallelujah.
Make sure you return here by 3 o'clock today. The Lord bless you in the name
Amen.
Of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We'll see you again tomorrow,
Amen.
God's
and
willing,
you
as we prophesy to you
that
you
are
gloriously
blessed.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
We'll see you again tomorrow. God bless you.
God bless you. We love you.
Love
Thank you.
Love you too, guys.